冇錯啦，咁啊鏡頭所見咧，308號車係海翔啦。嗱，而家後邊嗰部咧就係林柏亨啊，台灣車手。咁但係林柏亨咧已經係輸得好遠噶啦，而家係俾人叻。
其他車拋離一大段距離，但係佢都堅持出翻嚟比賽啊。
咁啊，點樣佢排得咁後咧？咁最主要原因咧就係頭先起步咧，佢起唔到步嘅，就俾人推咗 pit 啊。咁啊，推咗入 pit 維修之後咧，再出翻嚟。咁啊，當然啦，飛完之後體育精神，佢亦繼續咧係參加呢個賽事。咁但係咧，就如果同頭車啊韓強比較咧，就已經係慢咗一個圈噶啦。
係啊，佢唔單止喺 pit 度起步，仲係遲咗好多先出發添噶。咁啊，韓強咧仍然係遙遙領先嘅，佢而家暫時同第二位嘅崔岳嘅距離咧都有啊超過6秒噶。咁啊，其實韓強咧除咗咧喺之前啊就參加咗好多年嘅三個方程式嘅比賽之外咧，其實佢喺2010年咧都去過中國國內係比賽嘅，就參加呢個中國方程式錦標賽，並且咧係贏得啊年度總冠軍噶。咁啊，所以其實咧好多中國國內嘅車手咧都對於佢咧嚟講都好熟悉噶啦。
冇錯啦，嗱，對於朱大偉嚟講咧，其實呢段時間佢係排喺第四啦。咁佢同阿崔岳個距離有幾遠咧？咁樣其實同佢個距離嚟講咧，係差唔多有5秒左右嘅時間。咁但如果睇翻啲圈速嚟講咧，每一個圈咧，朱大偉咧係唔多唔少咧，係比阿崔岳咧係快少少嘅。咁即係話其實喺呢幾個圈裏邊嚇，嗱，8個圈嘅賽事已經差唔多係4個圈嘅啦，能唔能夠追翻上嚟咧？呢、這個咧就係最關鍵嘅時刻啦。
不過當然仲有因素就係而家崔岳同埋朱大偉之間咧，仲有一位車手就係盧家俊啊，就喺第三位啊。咁盧家俊都不容忽視啊！呢位香港車手都曾經咧喺澳門東望洋賽道都獲獎無數噶啦。咁啊，最經典就係曾經啊喺2001年至到2003年啊，連續3年啊奪得呢個澳門電信房車賽嘅冠軍噶。
冇錯啦，咁所以變咗咧，其實除咗係韓強一枝獨秀之外咧，即係話排喺第二、第三同第四呢三部車嚟講咧，係有一番龍爭虎鬥啊！
除了韓強之外咧，呢場比賽仲有另外兩位澳門車手參加呢場賽事嘅。咁啊，其中一位咧，宋志偉好可惜啦。咁啊，比賽開始嘅時候，由於架車起動唔到啊，所以就唔能夠繼續嚇進行呢個比賽啦。咁啊，至於另一位嘅澳門
9.7 the leader.
Right, let's watch the leader. Car number 38 as he goes across the line and 6 laps completed, 2 laps to go. Incidentally, the number 58 car behind, 2 laps behind, Hans Lien late starting, but he's not allowed the leader to get away. Showing you what he could have done.
Well, and I knew he would. He's very talented driver, and I don't think there's any question that he could hold the pace for sure. And very impressive that, of course, there are only, what, 3 Macan drivers, and here we go, another extraction needed as another victim of the famous tyres at Lisbon.
For a nice clean line around, but you can push these cars, lean them into the corner.
What happened? He just couldn't make it?
Yep, didn't make it to the start of the race. 2 laps down on the race leader. Race long, he's been able to stay directly with car number 38, Håkon Kern, who leads this race, the final race of the day for day 3 of 4 for the McEwen Wang Sanyen. So the leader with this ever-present shadow. If things have been different at the start of the race, that could have been a battle for the lead of the race.And look how much time is Hans Lien going up towards the left-hander with the Solitude S's from here and leaning the car. Too much tyre locking up from the race leader, do you?
No, you don't. And very smooth indeed. He's very through these S's and approach the hill here. And so easy to miss your breaking point at the bottom of the hill here because it's end for here.Just exactly what Lien just did then, locking up just slightly and then heading up Orange Hill back to Orange Hill for the last time. Here comes Maria. And down towards Melco for the last time.
Håkon Kern, it is that leads car number 38. Ben is now 2 laps down on the race leader.But that's the race leader that dominated practice, dominated qualifying, took position, has kept the car very, very neat and tidy, and consistently has been putting in lap times under 3 minutes. Did it on the last lap as well. Our final race winner in third place in his Sonova D70. David Zhu in fourth place, car number 1. Carlos Zhu in fifth place.